I'm joined now by Dr. Nancy Rowe from the University of Chicago Medicine talking about AASLD's critical session on hepatitis C. This is such an important topic right now. So many changes, so many advancements, but really that is bringing up so many questions.
Absolutely. It's rare that in a lifetime of a practitioner that you can actually see the recognition of a new disease, because hepatitis C is a relatively newly diagnosed virus, and then a window of potential eradication. So we are seeing monumental impact in how we identify the virus, how we link individuals to providers that are comfortable and knowledgeable, and then how we get access to the medications in order to get them cured.
I think there's been a big push over the last several years to try to find the people who do need treatment. What are the recommendations currently for screening?
So absolutely, and our screening recommendations will continue to evolve as we find that it's harder and harder to identify individuals with hepatitis C. But currently, anybody who has risk factors for hepatitis C, which is mostly exposure to infected blood, either through remote IV drug use, having a blood transfusion before 1991, high-risk practices, even some of the more iatrogenic things, such as hemodialysis, or more recently, because we recognize that a lot of people really don't have any of those risk factors, that just living or being born between the critical years of 1945 to 1965 meant that you were at higher risk for exposure because we didn't know what the virus was, and we weren't as good about universal precautions, so that we learned so much in medicine about how to clean equipment, what not to recycle, not to reuse a vial of medicine for more than one patient. And these are all potential exposures to individuals who had no idea that they could be exposed to something.
Now that we are identifying these patients, what are really the hurdles to treatment, because things are changing so rapidly?
So I think some of the biggest hurdles are just convincing the patient and the patient's provider that this is an important disease. Hepatitis, like viral hepatitis, is asymptomatic often, and so you're told something that can be kind of frightening, and if you don't feel poorly, some people are likely to kind of run away or ignore that. And if your provider, if your family doctor or the person that identified you, especially if you might have been identified in an emergency room or a setting that you may not go back to, they really need to be tasked with telling you that this is treatable. And if we don't treat this, this could have long-term impact on your life that we could have avoided. And so I think a lot of it is just an upfront explanation as to why we're doing what we're doing and why you need to know the results and what to do with the results once you get them.
And the treatment is so costly now. How do you recommend for physicians that they really do encourage their patients to get that treatment when they haven't had symptoms and have thought, well, I've lived with it this long?
There's a big sticker shock, and I think it's important to understand that wholesale acquisition cost, which is the price tag of the medicine, is not what the patient actually needs to pay. So that your insurance company or even like some clinics can bargain a better price, and there are other ways out there to help, even if you have a high copay, to offset some of that. Because of the high cost, it is a competitive market. There are a lot of new drugs coming. We think that that will have an impact on cost, but there is a little prioritization now, which means that some insurers or some payers are helping to identify the individuals who are at most need for treatment and treating them first. I try to tell my patients who are told that they can't have therapy right now that this does not mean that you have to develop advanced disease. It just means that for a budget constraint system, that right now they only have enough money to treat so many people, and they need to treat those that are going to get sick first. And that this is almost a congratulations, you're not going to get sick first. But it's still a very difficult story when a person's scared, has a new diagnosis, and really would like to put all of that behind them when there's a highly effective cure out there.
Such a perplexing time, but such an important time. And that's
Absolutely.
Why this session is going to be terrific. Thank you so much, Dr. Rowe.
Thanks for asking me to talk.